the punch. They got the caudal supports. They have their mid-ember spirit, so they're looking for their own offlane as well as a one hero. Plenty still left open, so we'll see what they choose here. Is there an offlane that comes to mind, maybe?
Meepo! Oh, who cares?
We got a Meepo!
We're getting not just any Meepo, it's Ahmed Meepo. Oh, boy.
No, it's going to end up on Bulba.
Oh, why would they do such a thing to me?
No, that's going to be Ahmed for sure. That's okay. So here we go. Now I'm extra excited. I was really hoping for a good series here, despite not much being on the line. But now this should be fun. So
and for what it's worth, even though Dialcom did not ban it out, they are extremely well equipped for a Meepo. Lone Druid has Root and Savage Roar. Doom has Doom. Crystal Maiden has Frostbite. Which the reason I'm bringing up Roots is because as of the new root buffs, Meepo actually can't poof while rooted, which is a huge pain in the ass. And any Meepo player found that out extremely quickly after the patch dropped. And then obviously Beastmaster with Roar makes life hard. So, you know, it's a show match, like you said. There's not too much on the line, but I want to see if anyone can handle an Ahmed Meepo. This team that Dialcom has lined up seems pretty well equipped to do so.
Yeah, it goes back to the idea that they didn't ban it for a reason. It's not like they don't know about Ahmed. I mean, everyone knows about his Meepo play, so they had to have kept that in mind. But as you're pointing out, they have a very strong team against it, so they're almost challenging him to do it right here. We'll see how it works for them. They do go their offlane, of course, in the end with Clockwork, and that will most likely be the Bulba hero here. So now Team Dialcom, they need their mid option. Who do they match up against? What, is there a hero like that's good against Meepo? The middle lane. 10 seconds. OD.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to bring him up, but we haven't been seeing OD very often, and I thought that, well, Dialcom's picking a whole bunch of heroes that we haven't seen very often outside of the Lone Druid, that is. So I figure, sure, why not go all in against the Meepo? The thing is that this is a very common trap that teams fall into, where they're like, okay, we know this one player has a signature hero, and we know that they're going to pick it. Let's pick a whole bunch of heroes that counters that one specific hero. You still have to deal with four other heroes on the map, though.
That's actually a really good point and very, very fair to make. Now, I will say, obviously, the lockdown is good against the likes of somebody like an Ember Spirit, of course, too. So there is that. They do have Doom for the Ember Spirit. I'm talking about that counterplay, in a sense. If you put the Doom on Ember, and all of a sudden he has trouble getting away. So they've addressed others maybe somewhat. But, yeah, you are right that it seems like that they maybe are really making sure to deal with this Meepo, so perhaps Team Onyx is going to open up room for others to do well here. But yeah, chat's going crazy as the delay is catching up right here.
I see Keepos abound.
Again, this is fine. I've yet to actually see it for myself. So this is he better own, man.
I haven't seen it in 7.0, and this big 7.0 buff to Meepo was that he no longer needed an Ag Scepter to have shared stats amongst all the Meepos. And what I've been seeing in the China scene is you get so what you used to do is you used to just spam Dragonlances, and Dragonlances got nerfed repeatedly. Now the, I guess, differing schools of thoughts that I see is sometimes we'll get two Wraithbands early on and then go into a Dragonlance. Sometimes you'll just go straight for double Dragonlance. Or sometimes I still see an Aghanim Scepter, just not nearly as frequently. Yeah. So this game, I'm curious to see what a real pioneer of the hero will be going for.
Safe to say a lot of people are going to be watching this, seeing like, all right, what is he doing in 7.0? One of the more famous Meepo players. So okay, enough about that. We'll try not to over-talk it here about it. But again, that's kind of the exciting thing about this series here right now, along with him making his debut. Again, this is his debut with this new team as well, guys. Francis Lee, as you pointed out, aka Flea, he's been stepping in, and he's done a great job and got to cast some of their matches, and he definitely was playing very well. But ultimately, I'm sure they're happy to have Ahmed here. And on Meepo, he's going to get the Bounty Rune to start, by the way, and it looks like both sides do get their two Bounty Runes. So not a whole lot of contestant at the beginning here.
Yeah, and then the other thing is that I've been seeing a lot of Chinese Meepo go mid, and that's what we're going to be seeing here as well. It's not going to be an Ember versus OD matchup. It's going to be an OD versus Meepo matchup.
Yeah, no, that's actually a good point, because now that you mention that, I guess, yeah, you would expect Ember Spirit to maybe be mid, but the few games I have been seeing Meepo, not mid, but other players, I feel like he's always been mid, actually. So that kind of seems to be just a new trend in general. And, of course, he's keeping with that. So that means, though, Ember Spirit will be at the top lane. being played by Mason here, of course. So, I mean, what's the difference? I assume you still build the same, right? Like the veil and everything. It's just he happens to be in the short lane.
Yeah, pretty much. He can afford to be a little bit more passive because it's not as important to get a lead early on as a safe lane ember because you're going to be getting basically uncontested farm, especially, well, actually, if your support gives up first blood, that may make it a little bit trickier, though.
Yeah, I was watching that right there. I mean, Doom just rotating over. He was not expecting that. A thunderclap from Doom that he picked up there from the Hellbear Smasher, and all of a sudden, Coddle's like, I'm not as fast as I used to be, so... That was a good collapse right there.
That's actually really surprising. Doom has 290 move speed, doesn't even have a windlace or boots or anything. Coddle has 335 move speed, so that's... Okay, well, nice stomp. Nice clap.
Yeah, catching them off guard for sure. So, big kill to start here for Dalcom, no doubt. EDC Smash here on the Beastmaster. He's going to be in some trouble, though. Doom nearby, but really not much he can do at this point. Just going to have to watch from afar. And maybe play a little bit of a distraction. Okay, he's coming in with the Thunderclap. He did get mana back. He's going to use it right there and try to slow up.
Scorched Earth on as well.
Kill that Scorched Earth, as you mentioned. Go for the turn on the Doom. And now Mason actually needs to run away. So I underestimated the potential of Doom coming in.
Not you. It looks like Onyx did as well. All three of their heroes have to back up. Mason has to go through himself. I didn't really think a Doom with just two levels would be able to be such a menace. And now... Looks like they might go aggressive. In comes the Crystal Maiden.
There's the slow Keeper of the Light. Dead of the Light or something. I don't know. Anyways, Coddle goes down. That's the point. As Crystal Maiden chases him with the slow. Say, as you pointed out, Crystal Maiden transferring up there now, too. And it seems like this trial in of Dalcom is actually doing very well against that of Onyx. And, I mean, how is Onyx going to adjust to this if this keeps up here?
Oh, they're going to adjust by having Abed Meepo getting effectively free farm. The other reason that you've been putting Meepo mid is because with the prevalence of bounty runes all over the place, Meepo can really take advantage of that. So an already healthy level advantage can just snowball very easily. And yeah. Once you get a little bit of jungle farm, someone else can take over the mid lane. And it's a really easy way to make sure that all of your heroes on your team are able to stay relevant whenever Meepo starts, you know, building up faster than the rest of his team.
Inevitably going to happen, of course, with that experience gain. And just start taking off. So, yeah, keep an eye on that for more than one reason for sure. Dubu here on Pudge. He's rotating toward the middle lane and maybe looking to make a play onto OD. Him and the Meepo, of course. He does have the hook and the rot ready to go. Just a matter of can he get the appropriate angle that he needs here to make a hook happen. But not going to happen. Top lane, though, looks like Mason. He's on the run. He's going to go for the TP. And that ain't gonna work. They do have the stopper, and that's a dead Mason there on that Ember Spirit. So it's not 3-0 start for Team Dalcom, and you know, is this maybe a little bit surprising that they're getting off to this fast start here?
It's the penalty. Oh, nice hook by Dubu.
That's good.
Smash trying to eat his way out, but not gonna happen.
Maybe.
Oh.
Maybe it will.
Oh.
No mana leak. Yeah, it's too much.
Yeah, because right now Doom and Crystal Maiden have bigger fish to fry. Frostbite?
There you go. That's exactly what you're talking about. They have. He's like, it's my kill, damn it.
You're already dead.
And there we go. So he got his power treads at least, but yeah, you're exactly right about that root buff in the patch 7.00. Right there, perfect example.
Now these rotations by Dalcom are working out really well. This Doom is being able to move around so much, and they did sacrifice the Beastmaster briefly, but Ember Spirit is so far back that it's not really too big of a concern if he gets a kill here and there.
Clockwork coming back to the bottom. Bulba, I assume, is doing fairly well. 10-8 actually against the Beastmaster. That's 13-1, so pretty just back and forth right there. Slight advantage for the Beastmaster. Speaking of him, he's going to run into possible Pudge hook. No, he doesn't actually see him right here, so unable to get off, and there's the first hidden tangle.
What a root.
He's going to get the shrine use, actually. And so he's not going to kill him, but a shrine use on a Pudge running away with nobody nearby to take advantage, that's still a victory for Lone Druid, I feel.
Yeah, that's absolutely worth. But now, if Pudge uses that mana to get a hook,
no,
never mind.
Yeah, well, I meant to say Lone Druid down there. For some reason, I was saying Beastmaster, but no. Lone Druid, of course.
They're both masters of beasts.
That they are. That is true. There was the confusion. Top lane, they're rotating around. The smoke ink. Oh boy, Mason, again, he's not level 6 yet, so Won't have those remnants. He does have the Flame Guard going to mitigate some damage, but the Scorcher is down, and Kali is like, hey, Illuminate, run away. That's not going to happen. They chase him down, and Everspirit's dead. So 5-1 start. Team Dalcom, they came to play here in game one, man.
Bot lane.
Oh, yeah.
Punch. And die.
Wow. Punch is dead. He got entangled there right before. Was not expecting that, perhaps. And actually, Bulba just has to walk it off against him. So 6-1.
The other lanes aren't going well.
No.
But mid lane is really all I care about. Is that selfish of me? Am I falling victim to celebrity here?
To be fair, it's what Onyx has to care about right now, because that is what's going to keep them in this game and not let it get too out of control at this point. But you got to figure Dalcom, though, they're going to start putting priority on the Meepo. As I say that, Beastmaster has a roar. He's going to get a solo kill potentially. Oh, there we go. The slow, the roar. In come the axes, couple of auto attacks, and that's a dead Meepo. Tsunami, I don't know if you've been a caster for long, but that's what we call a classic case of caster's curse coming out right there.
To have that kind of power, they say it's a bad thing, but me, I'm going to use it for evil every single time.
Yeah. So let's not talk about Meepo.
These support rotations from Dialcom, they're just taking a world tour of the entire Dire half of the map. Now, right now, Onyx trying to return the favor, going in on Doomtop.
They would love to get this kill. Punch hook ready to go, but Mason runs in front, but it doesn't matter. Wow, I'm surprised that actually hit Doom still. And he is going to die despite his best attempt right there at staying alive. But I thought for sure that was going to hook Ember Spirit for a second. And they're going to miss out on the kill, but Dubu hit it. Never doubt the Dubu punch. Makes it happen. So, yeah, that's got to feel good if you're on it, because, again, especially with the way that top lane's been going, finally some breathing room for Ember Spirit, it feels like, up there. Who, look at how far down he is on the net worth this early in the game. That's a short lane Ember Spirit. Sixth in the game right now. That's not good.
Short lane Ember Spirit with a Coddle for support as well, and I mean, even this Pudge has not been able. He would like to bother this OD mid, because that's a pretty easy gank for a Pudge. Once you see the Astral go up, then you can basically just walk up to the OD, which Meepo didn't have Ensnare and still does not have his Ensnare yet, so it's kind of difficult to get the setup for a Pudge hook, but still, Pudge would like to do things other than just have to babysit this top lane all day.
Bulba's actually, he's almost level 7 now. I was going to say, though, I mean, maybe as far as calming things down, coming back here for Team Onyx, it feels like perhaps using Clockwork to get some initiation. Would you like to see Clockwork maybe go to the middle or the top lane here, set up a kill?
Now that Coddle's come bot, then yeah, I would like to see it. Had he gone as soon as he hit 6, then Lone Druid would have taken this tower free. So if they have some anti-push in this lane, then it's okay for Bulba to go on some journeys, which looks like it's the plan now. Is Demon going to chill and make sure that this bot lane doesn't get pushed too heavily?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Kyle pushing it out. You got Lone Druid, though, holding that ground as mentioned, and he's going to push it back as much as possible. So speaking of Clockwork going elsewhere, he is perhaps rotating towards the top. No, he's coming back bottom, actually. So he does have a smoke on him, though, so we'll see if they maybe make a play with that. But you look at the bottom side of the map. I mean, Lone Druid is in his jungle, but everyone else more on the top side here.
Yeah, Clockwork does not see anything. There was a ward earlier on this Radiant tier 1, but it got countered, and that would have been really valuable because there were three Radiant heroes chilling in that second jungle of theirs, and really, Bulba's just looking for a place to go on the map. He wants to go where the enemies are, but he doesn't know where any of the enemies are, so right now they're just kind of walking around aimlessly.
Well, Dalcom, at least Beastmaster here, he'll just keep the push coming at the top lane. He's got the double boars out. Applies pressure to the tower. Doom and Crystal Maiden, of course, nearby as mentioned here. Level 6 Crystal Maiden, by the way, so that Freezing Field also ready to go if they get caught in a team fight. So they're going to exchange towers right here. At least that's the way they're playing like. And I don't know. I almost think I'd favor Onyx, though, because of the start that Dalcom has had. If they're going to be trading towers, that just seems like it's allowing Onyx to maybe start climbing back in a little bit.
Especially if this successful bait with Abed's Meepo was smoked up briefly, and if Dalcom had gone for a defense on this tier 1, it could have ended very badly. But yeah, I consider a trade to be heavily in favor of Onyx, especially because really Dalcom isn't doing much else after they take that tower. They may be able to pressure this a little bit, especially because Mason is so heavily under level, but it's still, Meepo presents a really dangerous clock, which, speaking of the Meepo, he did go for Dragonlance first item.
There you go, power treads into the Dragonlance, and He already has his Ogre Club for his next Dragonlance ready to go, and actually, yeah, another Band of Elfskin here, so he is going to be going the double Dragonlance at least. Talking about that fun build here. Roar on Ember Spirit. Not the biggest follow-up, though. Doom's charging in, but he gets hooked back. Now Doom is applied. However, Pudge now. He's in a bad spot. A couple of auto-attacks from OD. Feels like he's dead Obit, though. He poofs in, gets the counter kill onto Doom. Somebody's put under here as well. Looks like Volvo, the one, put under here to use his hookshot. Freezing Field is going to be canceled immediately, actually, by the Battery Assault, I believe. And they get the kill on a Crystal Maiden. So it ends up being a 2-for-nothing for Onyx. So Dalcom, a little too comfortable. The dive, it seemed a little delayed on the Ember Spear right there.
It didn't seem necessary to... Well, so it was early, but whenever there's a Remnant threat, you need to get the initiation as soon as you see it. And Doom was coming in, but right now, even if they do get the Doom, all they really do is just stop the Ember from immediately escaping. They don't kill the Ember, and the Pudge Hook just ensured that. I'm surprised that Dalcom felt that they needed to play so aggressive, especially they're playing into a Meepo when they have a Lone Druid who could just be pushing towers elsewhere. Lone Druid actually showed up to that fight, tossed a few auto attacks, but he's only level 11. He may have range, but he doesn't have any damage right now.
Yeah, that's true. That level 15 is safe to say is where he really starts to be a bit of a threat. Dismember, speaking of that, Doom's in trouble. Or maybe it's actually Pudge is the one in trouble. He has support nearby, and indeed it is. And again, OD's like, I got the skill, guys. Don't worry. Kill secure.
Yeah, it's just a return favor for the gank up top. Pudge can get initiation, but you can't get kills. So
no.
With these teams, top lane though, Lone Druid getting caught out, Roar is down.
That's not good. Van's dead, and there goes that, as you're just saying though, like, Dalcom, it feels like they felt forced for whatever reason. Now that they lose that fight at the top lane, they just lost their Lone Druid right there who got ganked in their jungle. That momentum almost seems like it's going away now.
And they can try to recover some of it by taking this mid-tier one. Nice blinding light, though, so they're going to be able to get this deny, I think.
Yeah, definitely.
Very nicely done.
They miss click right here, but yeah, should be an easy deny coming out. Double Dragonlance has been finished on Meepo, by the way, and he does have a blink, so we're 12 and a half minutes in. He's level 14, so Abed is most certainly finding his farm that he was hoping for, and that's just going to get scarier and scarier for Dalcom as we enter into a out of the laning phase and somewhat into that mid game now at this point here. So need that farm alone, Druid.
As we progress, also, since Abed has gotten such a good start, he's going to get this level 15 talent of lifesteal pretty soon, which makes Roche extremely easy for Meepo. And while they do have a Beastmaster Hawk, it's difficult to keep all of your attention on that because Meepo can just take it whenever he wants, much like an Ursa almost. So there's really good vision right now for Dalcom. They have a lot of aggressive wards up, but they just don't have the heroes to take advantage of that aggressive vision right now.
You figure Beastmaster could be good for that, but yeah, he doesn't have the Blink Dagger. Of course, he is going the Necro first here. He looks like he's going to build it into a level 3. Nothing wrong with that, but when it comes to that solid initiation, it does feel like that they are somewhat lacking right now. They don't have that Blink Dagger hero, again, at least just yet. So Beastmaster is going to make his way over here, though. That
Doom also is going for this mech, so
yep.
Hopefully they can get this on Bulba.
Bulba picks it up the Bounty Rune first, but yeah, he does have the Blade Mail's mentioned. Hook in the background, by the way, catches Crystal Maiden. All of a sudden, she's in trouble. Going to be put under with the Imprisonment, though. So the Dismember canceled, and Pudge will walk it off. Meanwhile, they get the turn kill, however, onto Doom. The ultimate is active on Ember Spirit, but there's not enough follow-up, and actually Dalcom thinking about retreating, although Smash, he's still hanging around somewhat. Don't know about that, though. The poof's coming in. They're going to use a Shrine to get there. And Team Onyx will be a full recovery, and they're going to smoke up and now go for some turn kills even more.
Hookshot's up.
OD.
They have vision on this OD.
Yep, that's a trap. The cog's going to push him back. And the hook, well, that'll miss, so maybe going to save OD a little bit, but that Mana Leak stun comes out, and there's the Ember follow-up. He's going to put himself under again with the Imprisonment. I just don't know if they have enough of a response, though. Doom, the mech heal, coming out the last second. OD's actually still alive. Some way, somehow, maybe he is going to get away. Another Mana Leak, though, coming out, forcing him to fight, if anything. Puts himself under again.
On Meepo.
Meanwhile,
in
the middle lane.
Lone Druid.
Yeah, Meepo chasing, as mentioned. He takes out Lone Druid. Back down here. OD is going to be picked off. And a triple kill for... Okay, I know my camera work isn't the best at times, but come on. That was like four different kills happening at different places. Anyways, four
That's
for one.
That's exactly what I wanted to see. As soon as that blink dagger was picked up, they went for the return smoke after Dalcom's smoke went less than ideal, and Abed made huge work out of that. Got the lone druid with multiple blinks, even after getting Savage Roared, and there's no real defensive play for Dalcom right now.
Yeah, they just need that farm alone, it feels like, but a lot easier said than done. You have the shotgun build now coming up for the Meepo. The Eth Blade is lined up here, and he's level 17 on top of that. So he is excelling as expected again for Team Onyx. The hook middle lane, going to just miss there on a Beastmaster. So yeah, in kind of hindsight here, just about talking about somewhat maybe lack of initiation. In fact, we almost see it right there. Ember Spirit, he's by himself, but they can't just jump him. And he's able to remnant away. Should they have maybe looked to prioritize a Blink Dagger on Beastmaster?
Either Beastmaster or Doom. Both of them not going for a Blink Dagger, I feel maybe a bit of a misplay, because while Doom is a fantastic mech carrier, it's only good if you can be secondary initiation. If you need to be primary initiation, which seems to be the case this game, then you need a blink. And same thing with Beastmaster. Necrobook is great for pushes, especially because they have a relatively good pushing team with this lone druid. But if you can't even get to a tower, who cares how good your push is?
Moves to the top lane. Yep, there we go. Abed here. Leading the way on the Meepo. Level 18 now. Also has enough for the Eagle Song. And then again, the Ethblade to follow. So they're just grouped up at the top. Going to kill the Hawk here. Scouting out. Not for long, though. Not for long. So kill it quickly and now taking Radiant over the jungle, but not going to push all the way to the secondary tower. Bottom tower is going to be pushed in by Lone Druid here. This is the first tower still up here. I mean, it's only 17 minutes into the game, so now that I'm looking at that, it's really not that long into the game yet. It definitely feels like it's been longer, but they're going to try to get this bottom tower, but maybe not, actually. They fall back.
Dalcom's scared. They have all this vision, and yet they can only see one hero, which is Mason farming the top lane. Rest of Onyx is protecting this Roche, which goes down, and they'll trade a tier 1 tower for that, but Onyx is perfectly okay with that.
Yeah, there's the Aegis now on Meepo, so he's a lot more comfortable now. Yeah, it looks like that Aegis, why does he have a point booster now queued up? So maybe changing his mind right here as far as what he's going to be going for. Okay, yeah, he is going to pick up the point booster, actually, so
I would guess Ag,
yeah,
but, you know, Meepo Scotty might be a thing.
That's true. There we go. Okay, he has it all finished. I was going to say, it felt like the gold he had, have it here. So, yeah, it is going to be delivered. So he changed it. He had an Ethblade queued up for a while, but like, Ag's a little bit better right now, he decides. So
he's farming at such a fast rate that really he can finish the E-Blade whenever he wants. The only problem is that he's kind of all slotted out right now with this Aegis, so they need to play pretty aggressive if they want to take advantage of it, because I don't really think that a Meepo Aegis needs to be like a farming Aegis. This is a fighting Aegis, and especially the way that Lone Druid, I mean, I mentioned a Meepo clock, but Lone Druid also has a clock of his own. He has this Maelstrom completed, and Mjolnir is a bit of an issue for a Meepo, so we'll see what Van chooses to go for in terms of item progression, but he's still not going to farm nearly as fast as a Meepo, so hopefully Onyx takes advantage of this lead that they have.
Yeah, not level 15 yet, so again, still doesn't have that plus 65 damage talent, which he definitely relies on for actually being a little bit more intimidating in this game. Necro, level 2, is finished on Beastmaster. He almost has level 3, actually, so I'm sure we'll see maybe that Blink Dagger going to come next. Speaking of that, Doom is deciding to get the Blink Dagger next himself. As far as his item goes, he also has an Alpha Wolf that he's devoured currently. So they're going to take advantage of that aura as they group up together at the top lane. Ember Spirit, not necessarily as good of a game by any means as the Meepo, as you would expect, but he's fourth in the game. He has a Veil, he has the bots here. And again, a reminder, we're not even 20 minutes into this game yet, so it's not horrendous by any means what he's been able to do. And they're going to find Doom right here. He had no clue that they could see him. The Veil comes out. That battery cell sitting on top of him. He's going to be put under with the imprisonment, though, for the time being, but I'm pretty sure he is going to die. Doom, meanwhile, he gets the ultimate activated on Ember Spirit, and oh my god, Doom the hero survived. So he actually gets away. Meanwhile, the roar at the top, they catch one of the Meepos. He's getting low. The root comes out. Yes, they get the kill, but the Aegis is going to bring him back up. So do they have a play now to follow this up, or is Abed going to go crazy? Meanwhile, Pudge locking down Doom in the background. with the dismember. Finally, Doom goes down. That's actually technically the first kill of this fight. If you don't count the Aegis, and that will do it. So, you know what, Dalcom? They got the Aegis used. I think that's actually all right for them.
They did. It was a surprising rookie mistake coming out from Abed. He actually sent all his entire Meepo team onto the lone druid, who was netted and then proceeded to Savage Roar, and it's a maxed out Savage Roar, so all the Meepos fled, and then Lone Druid just walked out. And when you have this many units that you only really need to send one to maybe put some of the Geostrike debuff on to slow down the Lone Druid, you don't need to send the whole entourage all together at once, especially because he wasn't going in for a poof combo. He was just kind of going in for right clicks, but it happens once. I'm sure Abed has quickly learned his lesson. Next time he goes in on this Lone Druid, it's either going to be a full magic poof combo, or he's going to send file in one by one the Meepos, as they might go in on mid lane.
They're definitely going in. The net's coming out. The poof's in, and easy tower kill right there in favor of Onyx. So, speaking of Axe, Caudle just got his own even, and obviously that's an important item for the Caudle to have too. Now the vision game, ideally going to be that much better. Currently nighttime, but when it is daytime, that's extra powerful for the Keeper of the Light here. Necro level 3 finished on Beastmaster, and he does have that Blink Dagger queued up. We mentioned about Doom earlier also getting it, but he is being delayed. Only 800 gold saved up as well, so they're trying their best to farm it, though. OD is going to be going a BKB, but also a little bit of ways before that happens. So they have some key items that they're waiting on right now. They would like to have before another fight breaks out for sure, but before another fight, we're most likely going to see an Ethblade coming out here for Meepo now, with the way this rate's going here. So, God, he's level 22 as well.
Which, yeah, now he has he actually went for the attack speed talent as opposed to the evasion talent, which is surprising because the one reason why I was very excited for Demon picking up this Ag is not only because of recall with this Meepo, but Blinding Light has been doing a ton of work. It's great against Lone Druid, it's great against OD, and all these heroes need to be able to do damage to kill the Meepo, because Crystal Maiden and the Doom and the Beastmaster are just there to keep the Meepo still. Someone else needs to actually do the damage to finish it off, and so I'm surprised you went for attack speed, but if you're this far ahead, I guess why not kill people as opposed to try not to be killed yourself?
Man, just kill them even quicker. That's the game plan. So yeah, feeling confident with the lead that they have. Thus getting a little bit more aggressive and arguably greedier of a build. TPing away from the bottom lane meanwhile. Both Pudge and Ember Spirit. You have Caudle. He's just going to run on out now. TP. And
oh,
no. Where was he TPing to? That was not to base.
Yeah, it was not to base. It was to the same tower that that all of his other teammates went to. Oh. Yo!
No way.
Yo!
No
Jimmy
way.
Dota?
Jimmy Dota. That's not happening. They eventually find him. I mean, he made it last another 5 seconds or so space created, as they say, but that was well played by Jimmy, a.k.a. Demon, there initially. Trying to escape, but yeah, porting to the shrine right there, like I said, with the rest of the team. Unfortunately, that second little bit of second longer is what cost him his life there. The bottom lane, but 20 more seconds, he'll be back up. Not the end of the world.
Really needed for this defense, though. Tier 2 getting pushed out, and it looks like the rest of Onyx just wants to trade towers, which early on we said that a Tier 1 trade was in the favor of Onyx. Now I think a Tier 2 trade is in the favor of Dalcom, but we'll see.
Rocket's coming out, but yeah, there we go. The Tier 2 trade, as mentioned, so Dalcom perhaps feeling a little bit better about that trade right there, but Ember Spirit pushing out the top. He has the Lincolns now in the works. So looking to finish that. More defensive mechanism and some nice mana regen. Ethblade finished on Meepo, of course. And he is level 23 and a half, just over even. So yeah, he's going to be creeping up on that level 25 here very shortly. And I believe we usually see the 400 health level 25 talent. But what would you expect to see here?
Usually, yes, but with an E-Blade, I can actually see the 3-second poof cooldown being a thing.
Okay.
But we'll see how this fight goes.
Oh, yeah, bottom lane. You know they're coming to hook, actually. Unfortunately, he got one of the Necro creeps, but it doesn't matter. Beastmaster Illuminate nukes him down. Doom locked down by the Pudge right here with that Dismember. He still has his ultimate ready to go. Mechanism going to go as well, but in the background, look at Meepo killing Crystal Maiden, as well as picking off the OD. So I'm sitting here watching Doom, seeing what he's going to do. Well, he applies Doom to Pudge, but it's just going to delay the inevitable right here. He's going to fall, and Lone Druid obviously got the hell on out of there pretty quickly, but Yeah, in the background, Meepo just doing his thing, locking down the teammate support. 4-0 in favor of Onyx. That was the most ridiculous fight yet.
We'll see what the play is. Yeah, I don't really know why Dialcom felt necessary to take that fight. I mean, they didn't really get initiated on, I don't think, but yeah, this Doom, if he's not... This is the problem that I was talking about at the beginning. Like, Dialcom needs to start fights the way they want to start fights, and the window for even the Doom Blink Dagger is, like, he still has it queued up, but it's not even going to be useful by the time that he finishes it.
Oh, Bulba. That's that hook shot pinging out. Yep, he's going to land. Catches Beastmaster. Obviously, they have the Visioneer on the uphill. Seeing it, the hook out, and Beastmaster most certainly dead. Oh, maybe not again. Somebody somehow getting away. Pudge, though. He goes down to the background. You see Meepo falling back. None of his Meepo seem too low. Locking down the ODS. He's being chased. They do lose Pudge on the uphill, and now Meepo, can he escape out? In comes the center. He's going to be poops in, though. And look at that damage coming out. Ovid will fall, however, just enough. He did kill OD before. Mason now, he's on the run at half life. So actually, got to feel pretty good if you're Dialcom with the exchange there for sure. Able to take out the Meepo, who decided to go back in and be a little ballsy there.
He was, I guess, in the face of a Sanity's Eclipse, it's do or die time, went in. It's kind of, as the Meepo, if you leave the fight, then the rest Radiant's of your team is bound to die. Go in onto Crystal Maiden. Goodbye.
A free kill there, as you see in the jungle, but meanwhile, the rest of the team is pushing out the middle lane. Now, Meepo.
Oh, what a hook.
Yeah, hook off to the side, actually. Catches Beastmaster, but again, do they have a follow up? The answer is no so far. That's Lonefruit, excuse me. Putting in the auto attacks now, but not going to be enough. Got trapped here by the neutrals. Ember does chase him down and secures the kill on him. He has no buyback. Meepo, by the way, also doesn't have a buyback. Could have sworn he did at the beginning of that, but.
He did. I think he bought his Evil Song in the slide shop.
Okay, well, his teammates are. I guess they're doing more than enough work right here without him, so. Not the worst decision ever to remain without a buyback. But yeah, that's second F play. That's ridiculous. Not going to be coming here for him.
It is the highest agility item in the game, so.
I guess.
This is how you play Meepo. You look at a. If anyone else shows you this inventory, you'd be like, that's the worst build ever. But then you're like, oh, it's a Meepo. That's brilliant. It's the best build ever.
Makes sense, right? I think, you know, I'm just going to say it. I think it goes without saying that they don't. They share a cooldown, right? So you can't use one
Correct.
After the other. Yeah.
Okay. No, you cannot.
All right. Just to really make sure on that. Because, yeah, if that was the case, it's like, okay, actually, that's not too bad. But they do share a cooldown. So, as you said, it's really just simply for the stats, though. Has that plus 40 agility coming out. And he's going to use it to help him do the Roshan here. And get that easy Aegis. Wow, it is pretty insane how fast he does kill Roshan by himself. So does that job. Meanwhile, Dismember on Doom. We've seen this before. Usually he lives, though, but this time not so much.
Oh, he lives. He okay. lives in the form of too many Dooms.
Kinda lives. And then there's all the Meepos. We got armies, man.
Units galore.
It's like a StarCraft match here. R.I.P. All right, Meepo.
Unfortunately, Abed had to retire one of his Dragon Lances to make room for this Aegis. But that's, you know, that's the beauty of the double E-Blade, you know? Who needs... It's all about upgrading your stats progressively, you know? You go from the mid-tier stats item to the high-tier stats item. No one really cares that Dragon Lance increases range. No one really cares that two E-Blades will share a cooldown. It's all about the numbers.
Yeah, that's why we like the backpack as well. He throws the Dragon Lance in the backpack, and as soon as that Aegis gets used, reclaimed, whatever it is, he'll throw it right back in. So he'll still be good to go when it comes to replacing that. Does he, I mean, okay, yeah, he is just getting another S-Blade. Okay, so it's just going to be massing the S-Blade now.
Oh, this Meepo down bot might actually die. Oh, what a play.
Poof out, poof out, poof out. Yes, he gets out in time.
That was sick. He E-Bladed his own Meepo. Oh, and now they get a root on Doom.
Seen this before once again. The chase is on. Mana leaks out. There come the poof-ins. And the Veil low. Now, one of the Meepos is low. You see how Ben right there panicking a little bit and pulling back with it. But there is no follow-up commitment from Dialcom, so he'll manage to stay alive. Let's be careful. But yeah, as you're saying, yeah, using the Ethlet on himself to help survive. Lone Druid just explodes right there. He does have his level 20 tower going to be up quickly, but the follow-up of the poofs coming out as well from Abed. It finishes off Crystal Maiden. And now into the base we go, says Team Onyx. Time to siege.
He still is Aegis, so who cares if it's nighttime?
True.
Get the hook. These hooks from Dubu, my god.
Yeah, they are.
You say we've seen that before?
Alright, bottom Rax is gonna fall here, and it feels like Onyx is. This is the beginning of the end now.
This is the beginning of the end of the draft screen, my friends. We saw it. We saw it all happening. Tactical Aegis reclamation.
So, Dialcom looked the wolf in the mouth and they were like, bring it on. The wolf just chewed their faces off. So, probably want to ban the wolf, aka Meepo, next game, I think it's safe to say. Because, again, you think at the beginning of this game, but they just wiped them off. I mean, you guys can see what's happening. But you think at the beginning of this game that Dialcom was looking good. I mean, the top lane was dominating. Mason was having a hell of a difficult time farming up there. The bottom lane was being won by Lone Druid. It was really just a bet, and even he died a couple of times early on. It seemed like Dialcom could have built some momentum. But then Meepo started doing his thing. I guess that's the best way to explain it, but that feels like that's what happened, and then Onyx just runs off of the up in Meepo there.
That and the fact that no initiation items on Dialcom, I keep harping on it, but they had these fights where you'd think they had good positioning and they had the heroes to be able to make sure that Onyx can't retaliate, but the way that Beastmaster and Doom built, it was more carry-oriented rather than the utility-oriented, and you can't really have that when you're drafting against a Meepo and an Ember Spirit.
This is what I think I love the most. So you know how great of a Meepo game he had there. You look at the post-game stats.
It's average.
Barely above an average game for a bit of Meepo. It's like, you know, it's all right, I guess.
I've seen it before. I've seen dual E-Blade, dual dot, Diffusal Blade. I mean, whatever. It's just another day in the life.
Lives up to the hype. That was fun to watch. But there's no way Dialcom lets them get it again. Like, there's absolutely no way they do not ban Meepo here in game number two. I feel like that's going to be suicide if they don't, so... Sure, we're going to see a ban, but it was fun to watch. It was fun to watch. As you pointed out, I mean, this was really the first match post 7.00 that we got to see with Abed Meepo, and clearly he's doing just fine with it. More greatness to come. So, anyways, guys, stay tuned. We got our break here coming up, but Game 2 will be coming up shortly. Team Onyx versus Team Dialcom. I'm Breaky CPK, joined by Tsunami. Here's my co-caster. Game number 2 coming up here in this two-game series, the American Region Starladder I-League Star Series qualifiers. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.